And welcome back to Fox 8 News in the Morning. September is Prostate Health Awareness Month, an important issue for men, as prostate cancer is the second most common cancer for American men. Dr. Charles Modlin joins us this morning with more on his efforts to help raise awareness about this deadly disease. Dr. Modlin, first of all, thank you. Always good seeing you.
You too.
And I'm used to seeing you this month because we always bring you in.
Yes.
Prostate Cancer Awareness Month. Still a major problem when it comes to men in this country.
You know, very much so. Actually, this year alone, in 2021, it's estimated that about 250,000 men in America will be diagnosed with prostate cancer, mm-hmm. and about 30,000, 35,000 of those men will actually die of prostate cancer.
Wow. We have a chart we want to take a look at right now, and maybe you can talk about this as it relates to who gets prostate cancer. Talk about that, doctor.
So
one in eight white men.
Yes. So all men, regardless of race or ethnicity, can contract and die from prostate cancer.
Okay.
It's a greater problem, especially in men of color.
Okay.
Overall, about one in eight, one in nine okay. men overall develop prostate cancer, but
okay.
about one in six African American males
okay.
will develop prostate cancer, one in five Hispanic males. African-American men are more than twice likely to develop from prostate cancer and die from prostate cancer.
Why is that, Doc?
So there are a number of factors that we believe contribute to that. A lot of it has to do with social determinants of health, but then there are some hereditary inherited conditions that actually contribute.
Like what?
So if you have a first-degree family relative, a father, a brother, a sibling, a son who's had prostate cancer, your chances for actually developing prostate cancer and dying from prostate cancer go up dramatically, because we believe there is a genetic component mm-hmm. to the prostate cancer. You combine genetics with environmental exposures, smoking, drinking, for example,
okay.
a sedentary lifestyle. These actually increase a man's risk for developing prostate cancer. I talk about the social determinants of health. There is actually dramatic statistics, and Cuyahoga County has the data also, showing that your zip code is a major determinant in terms of your longevity, how long you live, and that's related to living in impoverished areas, food deserts, toxic environments, not having access to quality health care. All of these things together contribute to the higher incidence of mortality, healthcare disparities, and even prostate cancer.
Doc, talk about the importance of early detection.
So early detection is key, and that this is something that a lot of men are confused about.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of men are reluctant to go to the doctor. They say, well, I feel fine. I don't have any pain, any signs or symptoms.
And that's the key about prostate cancer. You don't have any signs, especially initially.
Yeah, exactly. And most men have absolutely no signs and no symptoms of prostate cancer. You may actually have some symptoms, getting up to urinate at night, straining to urinate, difficulty
But sometimes
urinating.
That happens just with age. I mean,
a lot of times that could be a benign condition.
Yeah, yeah.
But actually, even benign conditions of the prostate can actually transform into very serious conditions that can affect your kidneys, your bladder.
What is the test involved, Doc?
So the screening tests for prostate cancer are very simple, just a simple blood draw, a blood test. It's called a PSA, prostate-specific antigen.
Mm-hmm.
And that test is a blood test that I actually recommend that you get every year. African Americans should start getting screened for prostate cancer at the age of 40.
At the age of 40. Yeah.
And not all physicians are even aware of this.
Yeah.
In contrast, white men don't have to start until they're about 55 years old, unless they have a strong family history themselves. Mm-hmm. That's a 15 differential based on your race. Mm-hmm. And again, it's because of your risk factors.
Talk about treatment.
So treatments have changed over the years. So traditionally, there's surgery, there's radiation. But more often, if we can detect the prostate cancer in early stages before it spreads, surveillance, we call it watchful waiting or surveillance.
Okay.
That is an option where the urologist is a surgeon who specializes in men's health disease. Well, we will follow that PSA over a period of time to make sure it is not rising. And so that is for men who have low-grade, low-stage prostate cancer.
Okay.
One important point is that if we can catch the prostate cancer early enough, it's potentially 100% curable.
Yes.
So we don't have to see all of these high death rates.
And that's why you get checked out. That's the key right there.
You get checked out, you know, with a PSA. We like to do what we call a digital rectal examination also. I always say every man needs a urologist in addition to a primary care provider, because we can interpret those results very, very carefully with you.
The health fair not going on this year, but you're going to do it again next year. Is that what?
So I have actually, I'm going to announce now that I'm over at Metro Health Medical Center, and we will be conducting our annual Minority Men's Health Fair at the Metro Health Medical Center.
Okay.
Next April the 28th, we're going to kick it off, and it's going to be in several locations.
Yeah.
But I'm happy about that. Yeah. We're still here to serve the community as we all always
You've been
do.
Doing a good job.
Thank you.
Have a book real quick. Show it real quick before we go.
So yeah, this is a book. It's a. It's called "It Isn't Difficult to Do It If You Know How to Do It." And what that means, it's a success tips book. This book is something that took me about 5-6 years to write. Mm-hmm. It's a book that I include a lot of information, wisdom, guidance that I've learned over the years growing up and on my success journey in becoming a kidney transplant surgeon and urologist. I want to pay it forward and pass this information to children, to young adults who wish to achieve successes in their lives. There are a lot of success tips.
Yeah.
It's going to make their path just a little bit easier.
Like it. Dr. Charles Modlin, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Always good having you on the show. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you for what you do as well. We'll be right back. Stay with us.